Alleluia. To us a child is born. Come, let us adore him. Alleluia.
We light the Christ candle to symbolize God's promise fulfilled. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given your only begotten Son to take our nature upon him and to be born this day of a pure virgin. Grant that we who have been born again and made your children by adoption and grace may daily be renewed by your Holy Spirit. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom with you and the same Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son is given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time onward and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read Psalm 96 in unison. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the whole earth. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations and his wonders among all peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is more to be feared than all gods. As for all gods of the nations, they are but idols, but it is the Lord who made the heavens. Oh, the majesty and magnificence of his presence. Oh, the power and the splendor of his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him. Tell it among the nations, the Lord is king. He has made the world so firm that it cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein. Then shall the trees of the wood shout for joy before the Lord when he comes. When he comes to judge the earth, he will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
A reading of the letter of Paul to Titus. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors. When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of each heart be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. I remember a brief, but for me unforgettable, conversation several years ago on a Christmas Eve at the Church of the Heavenly Rest in Abilene, where I served. Right before the procession into the nave, the choir was lined up, the acolytes with crosses and torches and banners were taking their places in the procession. Our organist was transitioning from the prelude to the processional hymn. The music was beginning to fill the space and fill our hearts and minds and bodies and souls. And the congregation was rising from the pews to sing, "O Come, All Ye Faithful." And my good friend and trusted associate, Roz Thomas, looks at me and says, "This is my favorite service. None of it matters without Easter, of course, I know that. But this is my favorite. This is the best." And all I can do with a lump in my throat is nod in agreement. The vast majority of Christians around the world are not gathering in person to celebrate Christmas this year. Without discounting our disappointment, I would like to speak briefly to that, reminding us that the Christmas mystery transcends time and space. We celebrate Christmas not simply because it happened once upon a time in a particular place, however true, but also because the Christmas mystery happens all the time, everywhere. Christ is born in hearts and souls everywhere and in all ages. When we claim, for example, that Christ is present in consecrated bread and wine, we are not claiming that Christ is present only in bread and wine. Christ is present, but not contained by bread and wine. Christ is present in our church buildings, but not contained by them. We may not be gathered in person in our familiar buildings singing the hymns together, but Christ is with us. Christ is born in Bethlehem tonight. Christ is born among angels and archangels and all the company of heaven at altars all over the world tonight. Christ is born in our living rooms. Christ is born tonight and every night in homeless shelters. The Christmas mystery transcends time and space, and Christ is present with you now. Like my friend Roz, the Christmas Eve celebration is my favorite. To me, it is the best. Something about Christmas Eve speaks to me, speaks to most of us, I bet, at a level beyond the mind and beyond rational thought. Having said that, I would suggest that this is something more than sentimentality and warm feelings and good, cherished memories. For me personally, it includes fortunate memories, Childhood memories of the family gathered around the piano singing carols, the anticipation of Santa Claus, the years of attending midnight mass, followed by the gaze up into the clear winter night with the stars on top of us, remembering the wise men followed a star. Certainly for many of us, this event is prone to the sentimental, and it includes the memories, and those are good things, by the way. Just as certainly, it is more than that. The power, the mystery, the wonder of the incarnation expressed in the hymns and anthems of this night. Angels we have heard on high, singing sweetly through the night. What child is this who laid to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping? Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light. The power and the mystery and the wonder expressed in Luke's story, the angel's proclamation to the shepherds, do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly, Luke says, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace. Far more than sentimentality, the story tells us this child is born into a world which needs saving. The cold, gloomy, hopeless world of the Emperor Augustus. And transcending time and space, he is born into any world which is lost. Any world which has lost hope. Any world which is suffering. Perhaps you are familiar with the 20th century German theologian Dietrich Bonhoeffer. He lived and died during the rise and fall of Nazi Germany. He was actually teaching in an American seminary when he felt called to return to his native Germany to confront the Führer, where eventually he was silenced and imprisoned and executed. In that apparently hopeless context, and while banned from public speaking, he wrote repeatedly about the mystery of God's love, and of all things, the power and glory of the manger and the wonder of the incarnation, not exactly in a sentimental context. In his collection of Advent and Christian reflections, Christmas reflections, entitled God is in the Manger, he writes about the mystery of the incarnation. And as I read from one of his reflections, I remind you that Bonhoeffer was a theologian who respected scholarship and was far from anti-intellectual. And he says this, he writes the following. No priest, no theologian stood at the manger of Bethlehem, and yet all Christian theology has its origin in the wonder of all wonders, that God became human. Holy theology arises from knees bent before the mystery of the divine child in the stable. He continues, how we fail to understand when we think that the task of theology is to solve the mystery of God, to drag it down into the flat, ordinary wisdom of human experience and reason. Its sole office is to preserve the miracle as miracle, to comprehend, defend, and glorify God's mystery precisely as mystery. In the context of a world facing horrific evil, a world questioning the power and presence of God, Dietrich Bonhoeffer faces his own execution for challenging the principalities and powers. And in that context, he implores the church to preserve the mystery of God and proclaim the wonder of the Incarnation. He writes, "We retain the child in us. We retain the child in us to the extent we honor the mystery. Children have wide awake eyes because they know they are surrounded by the mystery." As a grown man, Jesus himself will tell his followers, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them. For it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." Only those who have the wonder of a child will be open to and aware of God's kingdom, God's presence. A contemplative theologian named Ronald Rohrhauser writes about the wonder and awe of children. He says that familiarity, being overly familiar with something or someone, being overly familiar is the death of wonder and awe. That when we are no longer poised for surprise and astonishment in God's creation, and open to wonder and awe in one another, even and especially those closest to us, then we need to look at things familiar until they become unfamiliar again, until we can become surprised again, awed again, alive again. That's our spiritual task, he says, to receive the kingdom of God as a child. The adult, he says, wonders whether something happened or not, or wonders how something happened, and of course that's important. The child does not wonder whether or wonder how. The child wonders at. The child wonders at, for example, a baby in a manger in Bethlehem. While the scholars and the historians say, and I'm all for scholarship, but while they say, well, it probably didn't happen in the wintertime, and it probably happened in a cave and not in a stable, and it probably was a different Bethlehem altogether, tonight's celebration invites us to say, bah humbug to all that, and join the child who wonders at the star in the sky and follows it to the Holy Family and wonders at the baby, the Savior of the world, a miracle, divine presence, God. That's the world's deep hunger, our deepest desire, likely the desire beneath all other desires, is to know the power, the mystery, and the wonder of God's love. So tonight we join the angels and the shepherds and follow the star, for God is in the manger.
Let us lift our voices with believers around the world as together we profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God of glory, by your grace, a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests on his shoulders, and in his name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Wonderful counselor, we pray for wisdom for the world's leaders, that they may use their power to lift burdens and break the bonds of oppression.
Amen. Amen.
Mighty God, we pray for the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord, that you will multiply and increase our joy as we share in the harvest you have gathered.
Amen. Amen.
Everlasting Father, we pray for families, friends, and loved ones, that those who now walk in deep darkness may see the great light of your saving grace.
Amen.
Amen. Prince of Peace, we pray for an end to violence and warfare, that your authority may continue to grow until there is endless peace in every land. Lord of all, establish your holy realm with justice and righteousness from this time on and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Emmanuel be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man, of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast Alleluia. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Eleanor, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Amen. Rochester, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Shannon, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Katie, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Let us pray. Loving Word of God, by your holy incarnation, you have shown us the fullness of your glory. Through your birth in Bethlehem, we thank you for this holy night and for the holiness of your presence in the sacrament of your body and blood. Send us out filled with your love and mercy to dwell in your love, to grok in the fullness of your light, that through the overshadowing of your Spirit, we may be God-bearers to our world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God, who sent his Son to take our nature upon him, bless you in this holy season, scatter the darkness in light, and brighten your heart with the light of his holiness. Amen. May God, who sent his angels to proclaim the glad news of the Savior's birth, fill you with joy and make you heralds of the gospel. Amen. May God, who in the Word made flesh, joined heaven to earth and earth to heaven, give you his peace and favor. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sanctifier, rest upon you this moment and remain with you always. Amen.
Thank you.
Alleluia. To us a child is born, a son is given. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.